Okay, so hi everyone. We are going over lab 8 today, and part of lab 8 we basically have to write a program that replaces every word Java in a file with HTML, save that file in the same location on the disk. You can actually create a different file just to actually do this output, and it should basically read a file like welcome to Java, I like programming in Java, this is a Java program, and write it back as welcome to HTML, this is HTML program, an HTML program, and I like programming in Java in HTML. So this is how I did it. Basically, I created a new file instance for the input.txt, a scanner for that file. I read the entire program in the file but in a string variable code. Code was incremented with every line, after which I printed a new line in the code. I basically added a new line in the code. Once I'm done with reading the file, there is no more input has next in the file. I close the input file. I replace every word Java with HTML in the code in that string variable. I create a second file object, file2, output.txt. You can actually use the same input.txt. This will basically write exactly back to the same file. If the file exists, you should basically exit, but if you don't, you can just delete this part. And then you can output the output to that file too. And close the print writer the moment that you are done. That's the first example. And for the input that we had, the output will basically be, let me show it to you. Let's actually run it, and input is welcome to HTML, HTML and HTML. Good. So now the second problem that you need to implement for the lab is process all the scores from a file, basically read all the scores in a file that contains this score called text.txt, and print out the total and their average. And I did that in this program. Basically, it opens the file with an input, it creates an input, it reads all the inputs, reads every double, and adds it to the sum and increment the counter. In the end, prints the sum and the average. So in this case, it basically printed the sum and the average of the inputs that you saw in scores that was online. And finally, you have to do some object-oriented programming. Basically, you need to declare a class person and two of the subclasses named student and employee, and basically implement all the features of person, draw the UML diagram, and implement all of these methods. So in this case, I will show you that too. So here I have all of them. So first I have a class person with name, address, phone number, age, and email, then a subclass of person student, then a subclass of employee of person employee, a subclass of employee faculty with a date hired, and then a method salary range, which basically computes the range based on the inputs that we were given. Then we have a staff class, and finally I'm creating multiple people, which are faculty, staff, or student. I will save the recording so you can implement something similar, and you should start the lab as soon as I post the two recordings. How to create a file in Eclipse? I will show it to you now. That's a very good question. New file, and you can name it, let's say, input3.txt. And now the file exists there. That's how you create a file in Eclipse. Excellent question. The UML is optional like in the previous case. Okay, let's save the record.